There's so many fun nuggets that I forget or don't even think about, talk about in these videos, but some of them are obvious that are kind of fun. But since I'm going to expand upon yesterday's Behold the Light of the World video, in this video, I'm just going to mention that that video was 8 minutes and 38 seconds on YouTube. I blew the Silver Trumpet Assembly yesterday, number 333, for at 8:38 in the morning. 3.3, repeating 3% of you is going to be delivered through this, but there's other symbolism in it too. I'm also going to expand upon, I can assume that since you're a bunch of unclean beasts I'm talking to, you didn't chew the cud on, on yesterday's, when I was talking about the significance of 8:12 and the Light of the World prophecies. It's mentioned, the Light of the World is mentioned in 4 different prophecies in the Writing Testimony of Yahweh's Word. I mean, it might be mentioned in the Abomination of Desolation, Saul of Tarsus' writings too. I don't know. I didn't look. And it might be Luke and Mark, his rat pack, his members of his rat pack might have mentioned it. I don't know. They hijack things. But it's only mentioned one place in Matthew 13, salt of the world, 5:13 and 5:14, about being the salt of the world. And he tells us to be the light of the world. And the first conception way, the first delivery waypoint, the first 266 day for the Emmanuel man-child was, and his twin sister Rachel was 5:13 of 2 years ago on Yahweh's restored calendar. You just can't make it up. But then you go into John 8:12. He talks about it. And I'm going to read these other verses to you. John 8:12, and John 8:12 was the my 266th day. I was born on 8:12 in the Danites calendar. Not only that, on the Danites calendar. I can't remember the year right offhand, but the 1962 on Satan's calendar, but 8:12 on the Danites calendar. You got to be kidding me. That was that, like I said, Maher and Rachel's 266th day. Then it talked about 8:12. Well, he said Yeshua said, "I'm the light of the world." I'm on 8:12. I jumped subject. I'm sorry. 5:13 was their first. 8:12 was my 266th day. 8:12 this year will be the 266th day for Maher and Rachel again. The actual 266th day, if you will, because there's been six conceptions for them. No, that's not correct, because there was 2 miscarriages. Anyway, I think it's the fourth one, I guess it would be. Yeah, the fourth 266th day they would have had. I'm sorry. All in all, there's 6 different conception waypoints, but 4 for Maher and Rachel. But, 266th day, 8:12. Who can make it up? 8:12 this year, which is just 12 plus today is the 15 days from today. Anyway, then you get into also 9:5, John 9:5. Yeshua says, talks about the light of the world there. I'll read that verse to you here in a little bit, a part of it anyway. 9:5 will be the 266th day for the faithful witness twins, Uriah and Zechariah. Say what? That's why there's 6 different conception waypoints. They had 2. They had their second 266th day, 2 for the faithful witness twins, Uriah and Zechariah. 9:5 will be their 266th day, just 23 days later, after 8:12 on Maker's Restored Calendar, the 266th day. And he's talking about the light of the world again. Oh, by the way, I want to point out that Isaiah chapter 9 is the Emmanuel Manchild Mahershalav Kutsup, as it talks about a great light being seen to the walkers of the darkness. But you love the darkness rather than the light, which I'm going to expand upon that, but I'm not going to in this video. But you either love the straight and narrow pathway, or you love the darkness. I'll just leave it at that. And then in John 11:9, wait a minute, 8:12 back in 1962 was 11:9, November 9th, when he brought me into the world on Satan's calendar. John 11:9, he talks about again being in light of the world, and it associates when are there not 12 hours in a day. Huge how that ties into it. Matter of fact, with Steamboat at 7:34 p.m. in the 3.5 days, it takes us to 3 p.m. today. Wow, with that Steamboat number 115. But talks about again 11:9. Wait a minute, 11:9 was my 266th day. But I mean, chew the cud on it, folks. All four places he talks about the light of the world are the 266th day, either for his second son of his holy anointing oil in 2 different ways, and for the first 4 offspring of his. It actually, and that even ties into the first one the first one, 5:13. With the 266th day for Maher and Rachel, and also the 8:12 waypoint being the 266th day for me Anka was no doubt born on the 266th day. I know it's on average, but Chiefway's perfect. 38 sevens, he's perfect. Matter of fact, 38 sevens today, his altar's been uncovered 738 days for the lion, word lion, Lion of Judah. Tomorrow will be 739, huge. Same word as 740 for Ariel, Lion of Elohim. Amazing. Psalms 29, Ariel, Lion of Elohim. Same word at 740. Same word, Lion of Elohim. And he talks about, well, you're going to wish he hadn't smitten me in that prophecy. Yeah, that ain't going to be much fun for you. But, yeah, wow. Wow, so in John 4, Matthew 5, 13 and 14. But by the way, they were going to be born at 3 a.m. On 5:13 before 5:14 dawns a few hours later. But regardless, he touched both bases by causing on 5:13. It was July 4th of 2 years ago. Was that waypoint, which July 4th was 5:14, which he talks about the light of the world. But four places, John 8:12, John 9:5, John 11:9. Who can make it up? Anyway, John 8:12 tells us, I am the light of the world, Yeshua said. He that follows behind me will not walk in darkness and will possess the light of life. Walk behind me, the key of David. I said you can substitute Yeshua's references to himself with the word that his father gave to him and to his second son of his holy anointing oil, the word of Elohim. I am the light of the world. The word of Elohim is the light of the world. Very simple. Walk behind me. He was made the image of his father's word. Walking behind him is walking as he walked, and he lived by every word his father sent, proving what I said in yesterday's video about walk behind me. He that walks behind me, follows behind me, will not walk in the darkness. Wow. They went on to say, you bear witness to yourself. Yeshua said, whatever. The works that my father sent me to do are the witness. My father bears witness to me. The works he sent me to do prove that he sent me. I say the same thing. I have a greater witness than John the Baptist. The works that Yahweh sent me to do, the entire works that he sent me to do. Just read about the send away, send you the lamb. Pull departure. I'm going to expand upon in this video. The last video, send you the lamb of Isaiah 16. That's just one. Turn to 17. Isaiah 17. I'll tell you the prophecies. Go on in 16. I'll tell you how they testify to me. And go to 18. Go back. Go through the entire word. You pick a chapter and verse number anywhere and send it to me, and I'll tell you how it ties into the testimony, how it ties into proving he sent me. Now, I might not be a member of all, because some of them are daytime specific for different phases along the journey, but they all have, because this whole word's written upon me, because his word says so. It's just what it is. But I have a greater witness than John the Baptist. Who's your witness? Your father, Satan? My father, Yahweh Elohim, is my witness. He caused his word to be written upon me. It's just what it is. The works he sent me to do testify that he sent me. That goes along with John 8:12, by the way. We go to John 9:5. The key of David's amazing, which was just in yesterday's assembly or today with the key. Yeah, with the chapter 22, yesterday's assembly, the key of David. Going to give me the key of David. The one that hewed out a tomb for me. The value determiner, Shebna. The value determiner. I'm going to get his robe. I'll be your judge. He says so. The Yahweh's judge here on earth. Hewed out a tomb for me on account of you stealing from our maker. Anyway, John 9:5. Man was born blind, and they brought him to him, and he says, Yeshua said, the night comes when no man can work. He talks about the works he does that no man can work, and then he said, when I'm in the world, he said, I'm the light of the world. I'm the light of the world. But anyway, John 9:5. But then he goes on talking, spit on the clay, and he said, go and wash in the pool of Siloam. Departure, send away. The send away part, send you the lamb. To build that pool with that got the tractor here with that bright orange truck that was rented, talked about in the last video. It's the exact same color of these 13 bottles of the Michael wine. Who can make it up? Let me ask you this. Have any of you ever seen the color of the seal of that Michael wine on another bottle of wine? Any of you ever, unless you drink some of the same wine. Any of you ever seen that color of seal before on a wine bottle? I haven't. Matter of fact, I mean, it's a modern day color. I hadn't even seen a truck that color until that's the truck they gave us. I didn't pick that, 4 years ago when that pool was dug, the pool departure, that truck brought the tractor, the little mini backhoe to dig it. Amazing. The pool of departure. Amazing. Amazing, amazing, amazing. Matter of fact, a year later, Meher and Rachel were conceived on 8/18, the same day. Parallel in Isaiah 8:18, I and this children, the offspring that you're given to me, plural, are for signs and wonders in Israel. Isaiah 8:18, When I'm the Emmanuel, man, child, Meher, Shalal, Kusrath. I and offspring you're given to me are for signs and wonders. The Elohim is with us. It's just reality. Emmanuel. Exact same color truck. I didn't pick out that truck. I didn't care. That's the one they gave me. And if I did, I certainly didn't know the color of the wine seal was going to be this color. Wow. Pool of Siloam. Go and wash in the pool of Siloam, the pool of departure, the send away pool. Send ye the lamb. Watch the last video. Who can make it up? John 11:9. They said, Yeshua said, well, go back to Judea. And he said, wait a minute, they seek to kill you. His disciples said, wait a minute, they seek to kill you there. Why wouldn't you want to go back? And he says, are there not 12 hours in a day? Truly amazing. Tying in the steamboat, truly amazing. Not 12 hours in a day. So the 7:34 p.m. eruption. 3.5 days prior to tomorrow at 7:34 p.m. I mean, start at 7:34 a.m. tomorrow. He says, if anyone, this is what he says. They're going back he's going to go back to heal Lazarus. If anyone walks in the day, he does not stumble because he sees the light of the world. Wait a minute, the sun isn't the light of the world. No, it's a parable. It's a prophecy. But it's amazing because it's about talking about night here. And I talked about some prophecies for the night, even in today's reading, but in the last video even. But he sees the light of the world. Tonight, maybe. Things might change, but for sure. Tonight proceeds 7:34 a.m. So he sees the light of the world. But if he walks in the night, he stumbles because there's no light in him. Is he talking about physically? I don't know. I got a headlight lamp on at night. I walk to my tent at night without stumbling. Even with the bottle of wine, it's spaced out over 3.5-4 hour period typically, so it don't make me stumble either. But you're stumbling. You're stumbling drunk off the wine of your fornication to our baker. Stumbling drunk. Today's Isaiah 28, where he talks about my strange work, him sending me to you, precept upon precept, his diadem, precept upon precept, measuring line upon measuring line, measuring line upon measuring line. Here a little, there a little, so you can walk, continue to walk, stumbling backwards, broken and snared in the captivity. The lies that Yahweh gave you to believe into, because he honored your rebellious hearts. But he says you eat in your own vomit, you pass out drunk. You're drunk and stupid in that prophecy, just drunk. Drunk, 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 drunk. Off the wine and your fornication. Loving and worshiping your make-believe images of our Maker and his only begotten Son. How that ties into Lucifer, I'm getting to. He went up to resurrect, have his father resurrect Lazarus through his hands. But after six days, I told you they scratched the sixth horse in tomorrow's Derby. They scratched the sixth horse, so there's only 17 horses in the race. But 'tis the law will run out of that 17th slot. I talked about that. But 2+ days they waited, and then 4 days, he'd been dead for 4 days. He got there. 6 days, but my face is shining in association with 6 days, which tomorrow would be the sixth. Excuse me, today would be the sixth, by the way, of the count from that. But anyway, I'm not going to go into how that thing, but I want to get on the subject of the video, Lucifer. Isaiah 14, talking about the only place Lucifer's mission. It's probably the fall of Babylon, folks. I've said since the beginning of these videos, the beginning of them, now 1,618 counting this one, I guess. 1,618 videos I've said that throughout them, not in every one, of course, that mystery Babylon is Christianity. Christianity. Lucifer, if you read that prophecy, it's a man. It's your make-believe images of Yahweh's only begotten Son who stands in the mountain of the appointed times and such. He's a man that's going. See, your make-believe images of his only begotten Son did not get resurrected 2,000 years ago. You're going to find out he's in the grave. Who didn't make their nations to tremble and such? Because who is the main people behind the chief seat, behind the scattered descendants of Israel and Christianity? America and her allies, the most powerful nations in the world, who didn't make the nations to tremble. But it's referring to a man, and the man is your make believe man, your make believe images of Yahweh's only begotten Son, Lucifer, the morning star. What Lucifer means, the morning star. Wow, by the way, the morning star is up in the east now. I'm talking about the 69 from 9/11 in the east before, but the morning star is up in the morning in the east now. Again, traveling with the sun ahead of it. Wow. But the morning star is bright shining. You think he's your shining light, your make-believe images of his only begotten Son. But he's a product of your father Satan. It's Saul of Tarsus. Saul of Tarsus's boy. the make-believe image. If we suddenly got something you call the J guy. I can't even talk about the word. I can't even use the word outwards because it's filth. Filth comes from Zeus. Venus. Venus is the deity of love. Wow, this is... Oh, Yeshua's about love, love, love. If Yeshua was standing here today, he would say, depart from me, you workers of lawlessness, because I do not know you. That's what he would say, the same thing he said back then. He would say the rest of it. You turn over your tables, you call you thieves, den of thieves. How were they stealing then? They were bringing their money too. Wait, it was a prophecy for now. You den of thieves, he'd whip you with a scourge, cat of nine tails or whatever they think it was, with the hooks on it, barbed hooks. Whip your back. He tell you you're going to die and you're throwing your children in the lake of fire. He tell you the exact same things I'm telling you. But you've made a make-believe man that you call the Elohim himself. You say Elohim is man. Oh, no. No, 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 no. Yahweh's only begotten son was a man, but he ain't who you serve and worship. You serve Lucifer, the one who stands on the mountain of the appointed times, who's desecrated Yahweh's house in his appointed times. Today's the 13th day of his 14th day of his feast of the seventh month, his feast of ingathering. Tomorrow is the prolonged come and drink waypoint, the living waters that flow out from my belly. A man. But I ain't going to die. You see, your images of your J guy are going to die. They're going to be gone, done away with. Done away with. He did make the nations to tremble. You run roughshod over the entire world. Entire world, and you propagate the lies. You stand the mountain of Yahweh's appointed times. Your perversions of your father Satan's perversions of Yahweh's calendar. Sunday Sabbath, even Saturn's Day Sabbath. I could go on and on and on. Your boy Lucifer is a masquerader of light. He masquerades as the light, and he doesn't exist. He's going to be dead, dead, dead because he never did exist in the first place. He's an image of Yahweh's only begotten Son that you fabricated in your wicked, rebellious, uncircumcised hearts from the teachings of the abomination of desolation, Saul of Tarsus, who got his teachings from Saul, saved by grace apart from the works of the Torah, apart from the works of the straight and narrow path, apart from the works of tis the law. It's Yahweh's law, but whatever, we'll wipe our butts with it. Whatever, folks. Lucifer, your J guy is Lucifer. Clearly, Isaiah 14 proves it. Proves it. Masquerading, the make-believe man anyway, but masquerading as the Most High's only begotten son, Lucifer. Wow, you say, boy, he's got a devil. You know why? Yeshua said you were going to say that about me too. Wow, Lucifer worshipers. Every last one of you. Mystery Babylon, the fall of Babylon. Mystery Babylon. The great whore, the mother whore, Rome, and her daughter whores that came out of her Christianity. Getting ready to fall. Great is going to be the fall of her. That's indeed. And the stench of her smoke's going to go up forever and ever and ever. You loved your boy Lucifer. You didn't love the light. You loved the darkness. You loved the masquerader of light. Wow. You sure did fall for that hook, line, and sinker, didn't you? And now you're getting ready to sink.